Tonight, the NBA returns on TNT with an opening night doubleheader. Charles Barkley and the Sixers visit Chicago Stadium for a date with Michael Jordan and the world champion Chicago Bulls. And then we head west. KJ and TC lead the Suns to Seattle for a Pacific Division duel with the Sonics. The road to the title begins tonight on TNT. The last time the Philadelphia 76ers and Chicago Bulls hooked up, it was the Eastern Conference semifinals. Try as he might, Charles Barkley could not lead the Sixers past the Chicago team bound for glory, as another glorious chapter was written in the Michael Jordan story. He led North Carolina to a collegiate crown. He paced the USA to an Olympic gold. And last season, Jordan and company laid claim to the NBA's top prize. Tonight, the defense begins. Crank it up, another NBA season here on TNT. Good evening, everybody. I'm Ernie Johnson in our Atlanta studio. In about a half hour, the Bulls tip it off with the Philadelphia 76ers at Chicago Stadium. 15 minutes before that, however, the Bulls get their world championship rings. We will bring that to you live here on TNT. And joining in the opening night festivities, our good buddy Dick Versace, Versace for short. You're pumped up for this thing.
One word, Versace or Versace, one word only now.
And that's what we'll keep it to, just Versace. that's how he will be referred to during this NBA season. You look at the coaching situation here. You got four new coaches, Pat Riley, Jimmy Rogers, Kevin Lockery, returning to the bench. For Alan Bristow, though, a new experience in Charlotte, and he's got to be in Boston tonight.
Hey, I don't know how many times this guy's been married, but I'll tell you what, he's got nothing to worry about. He's on a honeymoon.
Chicago Stadium. 15 minutes before that, however, the Bulls get their world championship rings. We will bring that to you live here on TNT. And joining in the opening night festivities, our good buddy Dick Versace, Versace for short. You're pumped up for this thing.
One word, Versace or Versace, one word only now.
And that's what we'll keep it to, just Versace. that's how he will be referred to during this NBA season. You look at the coaching situation here. You got four new coaches, Pat Riley, Jimmy Rogers, Kevin Lockery, returning to the bench. For Alan Bristow, though, a new experience in Charlotte, and he's got to be in Boston tonight.
Hey, I don't know how many times this guy's been married, but I'll tell you what, he's got nothing to worry about. He's on a honeymoon. They're more interested in Larry Johnson, Kendall Gill et al., and a burgeoning team and selling teal T-shirts.
So a honeymoon that lasts at least one night, and we'll see how much longer. Now, this offseason, folks, has featured, as usual, some comings and goings, injuries and recoveries. It has featured signings and holdouts. And to get you up to speed on what's happened in the offseason, our Friday Flash with Craig Sager.
The end of a season marks the beginning of a new one. This week on the Friday Flash, we recap what has happened since the Chicago Bulls won the last NBA title. It has been anything but an offseason.
The most valuable player award in the finals was a duplication of the honor in the regular season. Number 23, Michael Jordan. The first NBA scoring champion to lead his team to the title since Kareem Abdul-Jabbar 20 years earlier. 2 weeks later in New York, the NBA spotlight was on UNLV teammates Larry Johnson, Stacey Augmon, and Greg Anthony. After leading UNLV to the NCAA Finals two straight seasons, including a 45-game winning streak, the three were among the top 12 picks in the draft. But among the early draft picks still unsigned, they are seeking contracts somewhere between the six-year $19.8 million for Charlotte's number one, Larry Johnson, and the five-year under $7 million for the number nine pick, Stacey Augmon of Atlanta. The season also starts without several veterans, most notably Roy Tarpley of Dallas, who has been banned for his third violation of the league's drug policy. Rookie Richard Dumas of Phoenix has also been banned before his NBA career has even begun for violating the rookie policy. The season also starts without Rod Strickland and Sherman Douglas, all demanding more money from their respective teams. While injuries have sidelined Dee Brown and Kevin McHale, John Battle and Mark Price, Bo Kimball and Charles Smith, Sean Kemp and Bernard King. Players looking for a job include Daryl Griffith, Vinnie Johnson, Ralph Sampson, Jack Sigma, Michael Thompson, and Kenny Walker. Familiar faces in new places include Michael Adams, Maurice Cheeks, Doc Rivers and James Edwards, Xavier McDaniel, Moses Malone, Charles Shackelford, Sunil Threat, and Spud Webb. And the Utah Jazz. Utah's new home is the Delta Center, with a capacity of 19,500, about 7,000 more than the Salt Palace, previously the smallest arena in the NBA. The Lakers tipped off the preseason with a pair of victories in Paris. For the fifth straight year, the NBA has yet to lose a game in the McDonald's Open. While the Bulls closed out their exhibition season with 8 straight wins, including a victory over Miami in the Hall of Fame game. So as we begin basketball centennial season, so begins the NBA on TNT. I'm Craig Sager. Now back to Ernie Johnson.
All right, thank you very much, Craig Sager. And folks, you saw Billy Owens unsigned by Sacramento. That situation is about to be resolved because just in the last 45 minutes, a deal has gone down, and it's a blockbuster. Sacramento trading the rights to Billy Owens to Golden State for Mitch Richmond and Les Jepson. This is a stunner on opening night.
Yow!
in a word.
Never a dull moment in the NBA.
Run TMC is broken up now.
Run TOC. Run COT. Run OTC.
What's it going to mean
to these teams? Betting. Yeah. No, off-track. Well, never
off-track
mind.
Off-track something. Now, okay. What's it going to mean to these
teams?
Well,
what's interesting, I think, is that Sacramento decided that they would stack and take the best player available when they stacked up those forwards, Wayman Tisdale, and then they had Antoine Carr and moved them on, and they got Lionel Simmons. So they can afford to do this. And getting a player like Mitch Richmond automatically makes them better. But what happens to Golden State? What are they going to do with Chris Mullin? Is he going to move out to two guard again, give them some bad matchups defensively, or do they move Marshall Onis in there?
So a blockbuster here on opening night, the NBA on TNT. Coming up, we're going to preview the East and the West. We'll talk to Doug, we'll talk to Hubie. It's all coming up, so keep it right here. And welcome back to opening night of the NBA season here on TNT. Ernie Johnson back in our Atlanta studio. The Chicago Bulls and Philadelphia 76ers will tip it off in a few minutes at Chicago Stadium. The Bulls beginning defense of their NBA World Championship. Let's get a preview of the Eastern Conference race from one of the guys who's going to be calling the game tonight, Ron Thulin and Doug Collins. Let's go to Doug at Chicago Stadium for a preview. Doug?
Thanks, Ernie. The last three world champions are from the Eastern Conference, specifically the Central Division, the Pistons back-to-back, and last year the Chicago Bulls. This year, the theme of the Eastern Conference race is going to be the knee is the key. We're going to go to the Atlantic Division. We're going to look at the Boston Celtics. We see D. Brown has gone down with knee surgery. Brian Shaw has been bothered by tendonitis in the preseason. We talk about Kevin McHale with ankle surgery. We talk about Larry Bird coming back off of back surgery. So a lot of questions in Boston. In Philadelphia, Johnny Dawkins, such a key for this ball club. The point guard gives them speed and quickness, coming back off major reconstructive surgery of his knee. New York acquires Xavier McDaniel. He's been bothered by tendonitis the last couple years. What will the long season do to the grind on his knees in New York? We're going to swing to the Central Division. We see Chicago and Michael Jordan. A lot of questions. What is wrong with Michael Jordan's knee? A lot of questions. Are there going to be surgery? So we'll have to wait and see. Michael says he'll be able to get through the season and be fine. Indiana, LaSalle Thompson has gone down. Knee surgery out 6 weeks. Cleveland, Mark Price, probably not back until January. John Battle, acquired as a free agent, has had knee surgery. I've not talked about Detroit. Detroit Pistons are going to have chemistry problems. You've got Orlando Woolrich. You have Brad Sellers. You have Darryl Walker to blend into that team. What will happen to them during the course of the season? So, to me, I look for the Central Division for Chicago to win handily. I think Indiana has a chance to finish second ahead of the Detroit Pistons. We go to the Atlantic Division. I still like the Boston Celtics as long as Larry Bird is healthy, and I think it'll be scramble for second and third between the New York Knicks and the Philadelphia 76ers. Ernie, it should be fun here on TNT. Take it away.
Yeah, we are going to have some fun. Thank you very much, Doug Collins. Let's talk now about the Western Conference. What a dogfight they had out there last year. Half dozen very talented teams, all with a shot at the Western Conference title. It turned out the Lakers went on to the World Championship Series and lost it to the Chicago Bulls. What will happen this year? Let's go to Hubie Brown, who's out there in Seattle. Hubie.
Thanks, Ernie. 1991, the power in the NBA shifted to the West. We backed this up by showing you the top eight records. Six of the teams are West Coast. You look at Portland, LA, and Phoenix, they're in the same bracket. Did Portland make any major adjustments? No. All they need to do is to have better execution when they reach the finals of the NBA or the semifinals. The Lakers, major move, Sunil Threat in the backcourt, giving them quickness and penetration. Jack Haley up front, big forward and center, backup in case of an injury. Phoenix kind of stayed the same. Made a major move now in trading the X-Man Xavier McDaniel to New York, picked up Gerard Mustaf, a good 6'10" young player with some talent, and backed up guard play in Trent Tucker, one of the premier three-point shooters. As we move to the Midwest, we see San Antonio once again will be right there in the thick of things, but they need to sign Rod Strickland and get him into camp early. This is a team that relies on quickness because of their passing game, Larry Brown style of play. Antoine Carr, major addition, a 20-point scorer, good rebounder, and a power type of a player. Now, the other team in this area would be the Houston Rockets. I think made a big-time move. Carl Herrera at 6'9", Turner at 6'8", and then the shot blocker, deluxe for many years in this league, will anchor a good, solid second unit, Tree Rollins. Now, Utah, moving into a new building, can they get the job done? No one has been able to beat them over the last couple of years in Salt Lake, only losing 5 games each year. Now, what we say about this club, new building, can they maintain that style of one-loss record at home? A great year, it should be. Style of play, talent, it is all here in the Western Conference.
All right, thank you very much, Hubie Brown. Throw into that mix, too, folks, the deal we talked about. Sacramento sending the rights to Billy Owens to Golden State for Mitch Richmond and Les Jepsen. And that just happened within the past hour. Now, what do you think about Hubie and Doug and their prognostications?
Well, first of all, Golden State has to sign Billy Owens. So right now, they have a player that can't help them. I think Hubie's right on. The only thing I'm a little concerned about out west is I'm not sure that there's not a pretender out there, a Phoenix, a Utah, a Golden State, maybe even a San Antonio will shoot in there. Now, in the east, I think Doug, you know, he's talking about chemistry problems in Detroit. I mean, they may have chemistry problems, but genetics are okay. They got an A in genetics. They're going to be pretty good. And watch out for Cleveland because Lenny Wilkins says, I like my team this year.
And if he can stay away from those injuries, things could be looking up for Lenny Wilkins. When we come back here on TNT, it's opening night. The Bulls get their hardware. Championship rings. We'll take you live to Chicago Stadium after this.
We are live in Chicago Stadium where the ceremony has just begun as the Bulls get their championship ring. Now let's go to Johnny Kerr in the center court.
Please join me in a Chicago welcome to a man many consider the best commissioner in sports, David Stern.
After 25 years, the great basketball fans of Chicago have been rewarded by a great basketball team, the 1991 NBA World Champion Chicago Bulls. Congratulations to that team, those very loyal and loud fans, the entire city of Chicago, and the whole Bulls organization. It's my great pleasure to give out the rings. Let's go, Red.
The rings will be handed out to the Bulls as TNT's coverage of Chicago and Philadelphia continues in a moment. Live at an electric Chicago stadium, the Bulls are receiving their rings. Let's go back to Johnny Kerr.
Thank you.
Bulls for a brief word, Bill Cartwright and Michael Jordan. Please join me. Billy?
We as players just want to thank you fans for inspiring us to the 35 home victories last year, the 15 playoff victories, and we know you're going to inspire us to get right back where we are this year with another championship.
Well, I don't think I can say anything different from Bill Cartwright, but as a member of this team and an organization and the city of Chicago for 7 years, it brings me great joy to say we are the world champions. Thank you.
Chicago, the 76ers and the Bulls. Tip-off is right around the corner. Stay with us on TNT.
The NFL on TNT. The NBA on TNT. And for the first time on cable, the 1992 Winter Olympics. Nobody plays sports like TNT.
Straight ahead on TNT, game one of our opening night doubleheader, the Sixers and the world champion Chicago Bulls. The tip in a moment on TNT. All right, Ernie Johnson and Versace back with you here in our TNT Atlanta studio. You know, you watch the World Series, they talk about the Homer Dome and the decibel level. They say, you know, there's a baby crying is one level, jet taking off. This was like at Chicago Stadium. Babies crying in a jet taking off. This was so loud here, and I know you've probably been on the other side when you're a coach and you got your team watching this thing take place.
I've been on both sides at all levels, from grade school, you know, up to the planet Mars. But when you're the 76ers and you're sitting over there and they're going, and now, and here's the ring, and here's the, and 18,000 people get replica rings, and I mean, it's just wacky, and you're saying, why am I here, please? And then, of course, the other team comes out, you know, yeah, whacked out, fired up.
Jimmy's got to say, hey, hold them back here for a quarter and let them wear off some of that enthusiasm.
Well, really, at the stadium, there's nothing you can do. They, you know, it gets pitch black in there. It's dark as heck, and then all you do is just stand and go, well, I'm here. Let's get this over with, you know.
Opening night off to a rousing start at Chicago Stadium. That's game one of our doubleheader. There are 24 teams out of the 27 in the league in action tonight. We take a look at the opening schedule in Charlotte and Boston, New York and Orlando, the Bucks at Detroit, a Central Division matchup, Washington and Indiana, Utah and Minnesota at the Target Center. Utah, what do you think about Karl Malone and John Stockton? This is the year for those guys?
I don't think there's any question, Ernie. Utah's a really powerful team, and they'll handle Minnesota. Minnesota's still going to struggle a lot this year, I think.
Now, three games are underway even as we speak on opening night, but also let's take a look at the five other games that we want to take a look at here. The Lakers in Houston, Dallas in San Antonio, Golden State Warriors and the Denver Nuggets, Clippers in Sacramento on the heels of the big Billy Owens deal, Cleveland and Portland. Now, three games are underway. As I was saying just a moment ago, the Charlotte Hornets and the Boston Celtics squaring off at Boston Garden tonight. They are in the first period. Here, how's your vision? 2020, Charlotte and Boston. You said Alan Bristow's on his honeymoon. No pressure. Guy's playing okay at Boston Garden.
Right, he's relaxed.
Yeah, D. Brown's not in there. and neither is Brian Shaw, so some trouble at the point injury-wise for Boston at this point. The New York Knicks and Orlando Magic. Pat Riley, what difference is he going to make to the Knicks?
I think he's going to make a big difference. I think Pat is a respected, powerful guy in the league. The team is going to listen to him. I don't think they're going to, you know, advance in the second round of the playoffs, but they're going to be very, very much improved.
They are just underway at the O Arena. Washington and Indiana. The Bullets did not win a game in the preseason. 0-8. They lead the Indiana Pacers 15-11 as they play in the first quarter at Market Square Arena. Ernie Johnson here, Dick Versace here. Versace, we will be back at halftime. We'll have scores and highlights and the insights of this man coming your way. Also, the guys who take it to the hoop normally, take it to the classroom, will have that feature. But straight ahead, game one of our doubleheader, the Bulls and the Sixers keep it here.
When the name of the game is big-time entertainment, nobody plays it like TNT.
The silliest looking object I've ever seen.